autònoma a Barcelona. Okay? And unfortunately, I'm not gonna talk about physics. No. Well, to start. So today, as you know, in Germany, nobody's working except for us. Okay? And that's because many years ago, the wall, as you know, fell, and something happens, no, after that. Okay. So in my country today, in Catalonia, nobody's working, or most of the people is not working, for a very different reason. Okay, we are in general strike, and the general strike is against the repression that we suffered last Sunday. Okay, so I asked the organizers, and I want to thank them for letting me the opportunity to read this. More than a manifest is a letter that is written for you, okay? So, yesterday I had a very difficult decision, whether or not taking the flight to come here. Could I leave my country after what happened? Could I leave my family, my friends, demonstrating in the street today as nothing occurred? My first reaction was that I couldn't, that I should stay. It is too much what I have seen these days, really too much. But finally, I decided to come here in order to explain to all of you, roughly 90 young scientists of all over the world, how I am feeling and what we lived last Sunday. In Catalonia, the elders always explain us the repression that they lived in the times of the dictatorship and how much they could suffer just for having a meeting, self-organizing, say what you were thinking, or even just for speaking Catalan. We are, unfortunately, get used to receive daily information from faraway countries where war and violation of human rights are the daily routine. What I could never imagine at all is that this could happen onto my skin, to my closest people in 2017 in the European Union. Policemen who are public workers obeying orders from politicians who the people have elected, kicked, punched, shot gun balls, gassed, repressed, and indiscriminately to younger and elder, which in any case were using violence. They just wanted to vote. The worst part of all, for me, is that the aim was not avoiding the referendum, which, by the way, they could not, with more than 2 million voters, but was generating something which was not in my country since long time ago, fear. That was the only and unique purpose, generate fear. Fear generation. We cannot convince them. We give them fear, repression, punishment. While the whole internet was full of images of their brutal repression, with up to 800 injuries, some of them in critical conditions, the public Spanish television censored these images. 21st century. I cannot explain myself the mixture of sadness, anger, commotion, fear, and hope that I have got inside at this very moment. Some people in Catalonia have a desire, a hope, a political claim, which is very legitimate, whether you support it or not, whether you think is the best option for Catalonia, for Spain, for Europe, or not. people are constructively fighting for it with weapons such as dialogue, democracy, demonstration, self-organization in an unilaterally non-violent way. This is our main weapon. This valve. And what is the answer to this? The answer is law, court, police, violence, brutal violence, and now fear generation. No dialogue, no solutions, no political negotiation, nothing. I am there to make a political speech here, in a place where we, from all over the world, gather together to sum up synergies to contribute to our common aim, scientific progress, in this case, quantum information. Even I'm not going to tell you if I do support independence or I don't. I will not discuss if the referendum was legitimate or wasn't, if it was the best solution for the problem or it wasn't. But I would like to make a call for peace, human rights, democracy and freedom. Among us, I can see people from North Ireland. I can see people from the Balkans, from the same Germany, and from many, many places where blood has been very recently dropped for political fights. Let's not let this happen again. Not anymore, not any longer. Political conflicts have to be dealt by means of democracy, dialogue, peace, and ballots. Thank you very much.